I like trying to be healthy. I used to drink a lot, but I've, you know, I've reined it in a little bit, just a little bit. I love wine. Wine is like my jizzam, you know? A jizzam. Nope, that's not a word. Let's not make that a word. Nope, strike that. That's not a word. A jizzam. Okay, or we'll go with it. Wine is my jizzam. But what's great about wine is there is always a new study coming out about it. You know, scientists can't decide if it's good for you, if it's bad for you. Like 2 months ago, they were like, this just in, one glass of wine is equivalent to 30 minutes of cardiovascular exercise. And everyone's like, fuck yeah, it is. Like, so excited, like, I'm in shape, you know, feeling awesome, riding that high. Then a month later, another study is like, this just in, two glasses of wine will cause heart disease. And you're like, oh, dead. No. Then another study comes out like, three glasses of wine is equivalent to Bikram yoga.
What?
Okay, though. Okay. Then it's like, four glasses of wine is like, you don't know me. I'm gonna fucking quit drinking wine when I want. I don't listen to science. But someone who loves wine more than me is my mother. So my parents are from the Midwest. I'm from the Detroit suburbs. And I don't know if any of you, your moms in their like late 50s, 60s, something snaps immediately in their brain and the house is covered in sassy wine decorations. It's out of control. You like get to our house now, the Van Poppelen house, and there's like a welcome mat out front right off the bat that's like, we only serve fine wine. Did you bring any? Oh, that's zany. Oh boy, we know what the Van Poppelens are like. Then you get into the house and there's like a framed picture on the wall of a glass of wine that's tipped over and it says, forgive me, Lord, for I have sinned. Uh-oh. Then my mom comes tearing around the corner with like wine teeth and a sweatshirt on that's like, you had me at Merlot. And wine is the only alcoholic beverage that gets that pass. Like if your mom had like a giant framed piece of artwork that was like an empty handle of Mohawk vodka, you'd be like, I think Karen's got a drinking problem. Let's all write our letters and trap her in a hotel room and get her on that plane. You know, but wine, you're like, woo, no problem. Like your mom can be wine drunk at 9 a.m. wearing a hat that says, it's wine o'clock. And you're like, she's zesty. She loves life. It's not a problem, she's spunky. I love it. I love being a wine drunk. It's pretty great.